Dangerous driving conditions in the Sierra right now. The snow is dumping. The wind is blowing it around. That's making for it to some really tough visibility and tough to see on the roads at times. It's only expected to get worse with a lot more snow on the way. Because of all that, we're calling this a KCRA 3 alert day for the Sierra. Thanks for joining us at 4. I'm Lisa Gonzalez.
And I'm Ty Steele. If you don't have to drive in the mountains, just stay home. That's the overall advice. Right now, I-80 is technically open, but several times we've seen traffic held because of spinouts. Chains are required from east of Baxter to the Nevada state line. And while the snow is constant in the Sierra right now, people in the foothills may be wondering, why aren't we seeing snow? Well, it's coming.
Let's go ahead and take a live look at Camino, elevation 3,100 feet so far. It's just been rain. You can see the ground is wet, but it's going to get colder. And as that happens, the snow levels will drop. Places like Camino will see snow for the weekend. We've got a lot to get through and go over for you. And for that, we've got team coverage. We have a team of reporters on Highway 50 and I-80.
And we also want to start with Chief Meteorologist Mark Fine and tracking the snowstorm in the Sierra right now.
Yeah, so we have a lot to get through today. We have snow in the Sierra. We have some thunderstorms going on. And over the next couple of minutes, we'll focus on the Sierra, the foothills, and the change we're going to see there in the next 24 hours, as well as the valley. But we're going to start with the Sierra, where the snow has been consistent throughout the day. During the overnight, and as of about 8, 9 o'clock this morning, most areas up here above 6,000 feet saw around a foot and a half of snow. And since then, it's been coming down an additional inch or so per hour, and it's also quite windy. Some of the ridge tops, we've had winds gusting up over 100 miles an hour at the top of the ski areas. So on Highway 4 and Highway 108, the snow level right now is around 4,500 feet. That'll be dropping tonight, but right now on 4 and 108, plenty of snow. Highway 88 is actually closed over the Carson Spur. You can still get to Kirkwood going up over Carson Pass, but you can't get there from the west. And of course, on Highway 50, the snow is still above Pollock Pines, but that'll be changing through the night. On Interstate 80 and on the areas around Tahoe, yeah, snowing. And like I said, up on some of these ridgetops by the ski areas, up at Alpine Meadows, they've had a wind gust of 152 miles an hour today. That's not down at the base, but up at the top, just howling winds. And here too, on Interstate 80, that snow level will be dropping. With the snow continuing tonight, tomorrow, and even into Sunday, we're going to be seeing additional snow. So here's how much additional snow we'll see on top of what we've already had. At 7,000 feet and an additional 5 to 6 feet of snow, and down to 5,000 feet and an additional 3 to 4. It's been kind of sloppy at 5,000 feet, but with that snow level dropping tonight, we'll see quite a bit more snow start to happen at 5,000 feet during the night and during the day tomorrow. Back to you.
You're right. So much to cover, Mark. As the snow comes down, Caltrans is trying to keep up. We spotted this plow on Interstate 80 at Castle Peak. This is before noon. On days like this, it's really hard to keep the roads clear. As fast as the plow clears away the snow, well, the road gets coated all over again.
KCRA3's Danica Hill's been tracking conditions along I-80 all day today. She's live at NIAC. And how are the conditions there, Danica?
Well, Lisa, I just spoke with Caltrans and they have shut down I-80 from here at NIAC to about the 60 bend. They say there's a wreck up there. They don't know how long it's going to take to clear, but right now they're telling people to get off here and circle around or wait it out here at NIAC. I want to show you around here exactly what we're seeing, just how many people are on the roadways right now. Right here is where those semi-trucks are still hanging out, just trying to figure out when this roadway is going to reopen, figure out what they're going to do next. We were standing here waiting because it was chain controls at this point. They say now chain controls have been moved down just a little ways down. They're checking down there, but eastbound I-80 is closed. So again, there is no estimate of when this is going to reopen, just how long it's going to take to clear. Caltrans has just cleared out themselves from over here. They say they're on standby waiting to figure out when people will be let back through here. But right now, people are being halted right here at NIAC, not being allowed to go through. They say it's a wreck. They don't know how long it's going to take to clear. Here in NIAC, Danica Hill, KCRA 3 News.
All right, Danica, thank you so much. Let's go over to Highway 50 now. We can show you this comparison yesterday at the same time on the left versus right now on the right. What a difference 24 hours makes. And you can see Highway 50 covered with snow right now. And you can clearly see the pavement yesterday, but not so much today. And you can see we can just barely see those tire marks. You're going to need chains from west of Kybers to Myers on Highway 50.
KCRA3's Jason Marks has been tracking the conditions for us on Highway 50 today. He's joining us live now from Strawberry. And as we can see, Jason, you guys are socked in by snow.
Nothing like a March Sierra snow, right? It is coming down, and it's been coming down for a while. As you mentioned, Ty, we're at Strawberry, just a couple miles from Kybers. And let me show you what's going on here. If you take a look at the road, Highway 50. Now, this is interesting. We just saw Caltrans come by not even 3 minutes ago. Take a look at the right side of the street. So if you're going eastbound, take a look at that, and then take a look at westbound, and you can see the difference. They've literally just came by, and already it's starting to build up again on the eastbound side. So obviously they're saying take precautions. Now here's the biggest thing we noticed today. If we show you down the street, let me step out of the way a little bit. When the wind really picks up, it almost becomes whiteout conditions. You can't see 200 feet ahead of you. I mean, it's that tough when the wind starts to blow and the snow is coming down. So it's something to keep in mind if you're headed out this way. We mentioned Kybers, a couple miles down. That's where chain controls start. They go all the way to Myers. And so they're asking for anyone who doesn't have all-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, to put on those chains. Even if you do have it, put on the chains. Now, I can tell you there is a group of people who like to see the snow. I talked with a tow truck driver a little while ago who says he's happy to see the snow, of course, but it's not for everyone.
This is incredible, guys. We've been waiting for a real snowstorm this entire winter. We've all been praying for it. The hype is real. This is a real snowstorm. We're still expecting 2 to 3 feet of snow today and tonight, with possibly another foot or two tomorrow. We're expecting 5 to 6 feet of snow at lake level for this whole storm. We're already probably at a foot, foot and a half, probably on the ground already. We're having a blast. Very dangerous, though. Please be safe. Us tow truck guys love this stuff, but regular vehicles that don't have the proper chains or tire requirements aren't going to do as good as our equipment.
Yeah, their equipment's heavy, of course, and they have the traction to stay on the road, and they're pulling a lot of people out. They're going to be very busy over the next 24 hours as it continues to snow here. But they're asking for you, if you can stay off the roads, just do it. It's probably the best thing to do right now. Now back to you guys.
All right, Jason, stay safe and stay warm. Thanks for that update. And the snowstorm has forced many Tahoe area ski resorts to shut down. It's a look at conditions at Palisades right now. It was among the resorts to close because of high winds and heavy snow. It's just not safe on those lifts. You can see visibility was not good, especially at the top of the mountains. Skiers and snowboarders should keep an eye on ski resort websites to know if they're open or closed.
We've been focusing on the Sierra. Now we want to turn our attention to people in the down the hill, places like Camino in the foothills. This is a live look right now from Camino. So far, it's been in the 40s, not cold enough for snow, but it is coming. As those temperatures drop, so will the snow levels. For that part of the coverage, let's go over to Chief Meteorologist Mark Finan.
Yeah, there has been a little confusion over the last couple of days about just what we are expecting in the foothills. Right now, as you heard, we are still seeing it just be a little bit too warm to get any snow in the foothills. But that will be changing tonight. Got a good thunderstorm going on right now in parts of El Dorado and Placer County. Some good downpours here along Highway 49 and up toward 193 toward the Georgetown area. And farther to the south, we also have some pretty good rain that's been going through Sonora. But in Groveland and Sonora, again, just too warm to get anything in the way of snow. But that's going to be changing tonight. I'm going to show you two versions of the foothills. First, I'm going to start in areas from Highway 50 to the north, and then I'll show you Highway 50 to the south. So this is the way Futurecast shows it at 7:30 tonight. And what we're going to pay attention to is where this rain snow line. So here's Grass Valley, there's Nevada City, here's Auburn, here's Placerville, Camino would be right here. So this is at 7:30 tonight. Colder air is going to come in so that by midnight, that snow level, all of a sudden it's down to Nevada City. It's just outside of Placerville. It's into Camino. It's getting into Georgetown. So that's at midnight. And as we go through the night, we'll see occasional snow. This is 8 o'clock in the morning. So you may wake up to a coating of fresh snow above Highway 49, but it might not be snowing. But now that the cold air is here, what we're going to see is anytime we get some precipitation comes by, it starts to snow again. So this is 2 o'clock in the afternoon. See where that rain snow line is, but it's not like it snows continuously. And then we get a little bit of a break from it. That's at 6 o'clock in the evening. So we see on again, off again snow with the snow level around 2,500 feet. With that in mind, let me show you how much snow we may see at some of those locations. Nevada City may see 6 to 8 inches of snow, but a place like Alta farther up the hill could see 18 to 24. Forest Hill could see more than a foot to a foot and a half. And Pioneer at 3,500, 18 to 24. So let's go a little farther to the south. So now here's Highway 88, here's Highway 4, and there's Sonora. This is around 10 o'clock at night, and you can see, look at Arnold. That's at 4,000 feet. They're just getting rain. But as we go through the night, by 2 a.m., now Arnold is getting into the snow. And then during the overnight, we see the snow level eventually get down to areas east of Sonora. At 7 o'clock in the morning, things are relatively dry, but you can see the on-again, off-again nature of the snow, but it's certainly cold enough for snow. 4 o'clock in the afternoon, look at that, snow from Murphy's right here, and then up on Highway 88, certainly snowing in places like Volcano and Pioneer, but it's that on-again, off-again nature that'll keep the snow amounts down, but you will be cold enough for snow. So now let me show you some of the other totals we may see here in the foothills. Murphy's, yeah, maybe only 1 to 2 inches of snow, but Arnold, more than 2 feet of snow. Miwok Village at 4,600, about 30 inches of snow. So for all of these lower elevations where you've just been getting rain, this is the snow you're expecting. It starts tonight and lasts all the way into Sunday morning. Back to you.
All right, Mark, thank you. Great explanation of all that. While the snow has been constant today, the rain's been more hit and miss. This was a downpour that moved over our station in downtown Sacramento during the noon hour. We could hear the roar of the rain overhead. Didn't last very long, though. This is how it's gone today, kind of on again, off again. Some places getting rain, others not getting much at all.
Yeah, that's been the story in the valley. Our sky cameras give us a good look at that as well. Here's a live look at Fairfield, Sacramento, Rancho Cordova, and Stockton. Look at those. Oh, we got a rainbow in Stockton right now. Check that out. That is very cool. Rain showers moving through from time to time throughout the day. Let's go back to Mark for a look at who's seeing rain right now.
Yes, we've talked about the Sierra. We've talked about the foothills. Now let's talk about the valley where we have these on again, off again showers. And this is the way it's going to go through the weekend. While the snow will be constant in the Sierra and kind of on again, off again in the foothills, for the valley, yeah, we're going to see periods of rain. Now, don't get me wrong. Some of these periods of rain will be pretty good. We've had some pretty good downpours today, and we're going to continue to see Doppler look like this through the weekend. So for Sacramento, for instance, dry right now, but you're holding up to go back to Dixon before you find the rain. Really good rain around Stockton. You just saw the rainbow there. It's because of this cell that's moving off to the east and to the north, and Modesto and Escalon and Waterford are all dry right now, but this is the way the weekend is going to go in the valley. Not all day rains, but we'll see occasional downpours from time to time. Like we're seeing right now, there's one that's going through Fairfield on Interstate 80. We'll talk more about the weekend weather and when all of this will start to clear out in just a couple of minutes.
All right, Mark, thank you. We want to see what you're seeing where you are. Please send us your pictures of the snow, the rain, whatever the weather is. You can do that at kcra.com or the KCRA3 app. Just click the upload tab. We'd also love to get snow reports from those of you in the snow. How much snow have you seen fall at your house? If you want to pull out a ruler and show us that way, that would be awesome. We'd love to see those videos and those pictures. We'd love for you to give us a little snow report.